from somewhere, and I'm seeing a litmus test develop right now. And the question is, can people like Tom Cole, can people like Aaron Schock keep it from reaching the level of, to prove your conservative credentials, right, you need to vote for a shutdown?
Congressman, what do you have to say to that about the litmus test and that
First of all, remember, my town halls were a lot tougher when Obamacare was proposed. I had 1,000 people showing up. This isn't a new thing, and we're not in some sort of self-created box. This law is extraordinarily unpopular. Never polled it well in any poll at all.
To just interrupt you for a moment, there wasn't the split in the Republican Party that there is now back in 2000, back when Obamacare was first proposed.
There's not a split in opinion about Obamacare. There's a split in opinion about the appropriate way to oppose it. That's a tactical debate. That's not some deep philosophical fissure. And look, if we were hurt, when the president was elected, he had total control of the House. We have the majority now, second largest in our history. You know, he had a 60-40 control in the Senate. There's now 46 Republican senators. We have 30 governors. So again, this idea that somehow what the president has done is put us in a box and on the road to extinction is just simply wrong. I don't think so. You know, it's a bad law. And if it was a good law, then the Democrats wouldn't have lost the majority as decisively as they did in 2010, or would have certainly recaptured it when the president won the presidency in 2012.
But Congressman, there is some concern, and I think you'll find conservatives that agree that Obamacare very likely may be very popular with Americans once it is actually in effect. I mean, there's some conservatives who say you're going to get Americans sucking off yet another teat of the government. Now,
I've been hearing that for 4 years, how sooner or later it was going to be popular. It's never been popular.
Well, but it hasn't.
Parts of it are in effect now. We were told it would be popular within a couple of years, a certain thing. It's just simply not.
But in all fairness, Congressman,
if it was working, you wouldn't be pushing back the business mandate.
Okay, let me move on to another piece of this, which is, given, you know, you've highlighted the fact that it's being implemented, parts of it are being implemented in sort of a sporadic fashion across the country. And you now have a situation where some states are expanding Medicaid rolls and setting up exchanges, and other states are not. Your state is not expanding the Medicaid rolls. Nearby in Arkansas, they are. Now, the expansion of Medicaid is going to really go towards private insurers, but nonetheless, you are going to have two neighboring states, one of which is yours, where poor people are going to have access to health care in one state and not in another. Are you at all concerned about that dynamic?
Well, first of all, that's a state issue, and the state's allowed to make its choice. 34 states, by the way. It's not as if Oklahoma's out there all alone. The majority of states don't like this or worried about the cost. So, you know, again, I'll let the governor and state legislature make their own decisions. They seem to be very much more popular than the president is in this state, probably much better aware of what people here want them to do.
Congressman, Karen Finney has a question for you.
Well, you know, Congressman, I guess here's what I find so disturbing in all of this. I mean, you were talking about some of the ways that you've been willing to work with the administration and work with Democrats to improve the law. So, I mean, we're talking about the health and well-being of our people here. This is not some philosophical argument. We're literally talking, for some people, this is life and death. So why would the strategy not be to continue to work on making the law better instead of this ridiculous repeal? It used to be repeal and replace, and now it's just simply a repeal message. I mean, at some point, is there not a moral obligation to people?
Well, of course there's a moral obligation to people, and if you think the policies that are being pursued are ultimately destructive and self-defeating and frankly bankrupting, then you have an obligation to continue to oppose.
Now, but you know, Congressman, there's been so much misinformation about what the law really is. Why not focus on what you can change and make better?
Well, I think we have focused on what. That's why there's 7 bills, $62 billion worth of savings, reduced regulations. We have been able to do some things, and perhaps after the next elections or during the next year, we'll be able to do more. We'll know more about the bill as it unfolds and we see how it actually, quote, works out.
The law.
But again, I'm sorry, it's just simply not popular. It's never been. I mean, look at the polls. You can't find a poll where people like it.
Congressman, we don't have that much more time, but I do want to ask you your opinion. If the suicide, I know that you don't think they will, but if the Republican Party succeeds in shutting down the government in the fall, do you think it will have repercussions in 2014?
Oh, absolutely do. Look, I've always been an opponent of shutting down a government. I think you have an obligation to govern. When you've been given a majority, you have an obligation to try and get things done. And, you know, if you've got a divided government, as we do now, you have an obligation to try and reach across the aisle and work for the other side where you can.
Cooler heads, let them prevail. Congressman Tom Cole from Oklahoma's 4th District, thank you for your time. Good luck in those town halls.